Hi students, welcome back to our online biology class. Last week some students asked me doubt about myelin sheath, oligodendrocyte and Schwann cells. After that we can move to our portion. The neuron contains a long filament called axon, and this axon is repeatedly encircled by a sheath called Schwann cells. You can see it in the video. Repeatedly it encircles, not one or two times, lot of times it encircles the axon. And in the Schwann cells you can see a membrane which is made up of lipid, and that lipid white membrane are called the myelin sheath. Okay, and this Schwann cells are seen in the nerve cells only. Next is oligodendrocyte. Oligodendrocyte is mainly seen in the brain and the spinal cord. What it is doing is it also produces a myelin sheath. The shape of oligodendrocyte is totally different. It consists of a lot of branches are there. It combines with different parts of the axon, and there it undergoes encircling and prepares the myelin sheath. Once again, oligodendrocyte only seen in the brain and the spinal cord, but Schwann cells are seen in the nerve cells. White matter and gray matter. White matter means myelinated neurons. What do you know, myelinated neurons? The presence of myelin sheath is called the myelinated neurons. Myelinated neurons are called the white matter, and non-myelinated neurons are called the gray matter. That means myelin sheath is absent in that particular area. In the brain, gray matter is seen outside and white matter is seen inside. But in the spinal cord, gray matter is seen inside and white matter is seen outside. That is the difference between brain and spinal cord. Today our topic is about nervous system. The nervous system controls and coordinates all the life activities in our body. The nervous systems are classified into two: central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system . It is also called CNS. Second one is the peripheral nervous system. Peripheral nervous system, it is also called PNS. The central nervous system consists of brain and spinal cord. And peripheral nervous system consists of cranial nerves, with 12 pair, and spinal nerves with 31 pair. Okay, once again, the nervous systems are classified into two. One is the central nervous system. It is also called CNS, which contains brain and spinal cord. Second one is the peripheral nervous system. It is also called PNS, and it consists of cranial nerves with 12 pair and spinal nerves with 31 pair. Brain. Brain is the center part of the nervous system. The brain is protected by hard skull. It contains three layers are there, which is called the meninges. The brain contains three-layered membrane called meninges, and in the innermost layer there is a fluid called cerebrospinal fluid, which is also called CSF. This fluid is also seen in the ventricles of the brain. There is a peculiarity in cerebrospinal fluid. That means it is obtained from the blood and it is reabsorbed into the blood itself. The peculiarity of cerebrospinal fluid is it is obtained from the blood and it is reabsorbed into the blood itself. This cerebrospinal fluid has function. Three functions are there. It provides nutrients and oxygen to the tissues of the brain. Second one, it regulates pressure inside the brain. It also protects the brain from injuries. So, we all know that the brain is the controller of the whole body. Next, we will learn the different parts and the functions of the brain. The brain contains parts such as cerebrum, cerebellum, thalamus, hypothalamus, medulla oblongata. Okay, this is the structure of the brain. The brain contains parts such as cerebrum, this one, cerebellum, thalamus, this is the part, thalamus, hypothalamus, below to the thalamus, and this one is the medulla oblongata. So our first topic is cerebrum. This cerebrum contains folds and fissures are present. And here in the cerebrum, outer part is called cortex, which is made up of gray matter, and inner part is made up of white matter, which is called the medulla. Cerebrum is the largest part, which contains folds and grooves are present. Here, outer part is called the cortex, which is gray matter, and inner part is called the medulla, which has the white matter. The function of cerebrum is, it is a center of thought. What all things, thinking, imagination, memory, intelligence, all these things are controlled by the cerebrum. And also it controls the sensational activities. That means seeing, hearing, tasting, touching, all these sensory activities are also controlled by the cerebrum. And here it controls the voluntary movement. What do you mean by voluntary movement? The movement that take place by our will. That means walking, jumping, all these activities are controlled by our will. That is called the voluntary movement. Second one is the cerebellum. Cerebellum is the second largest part of the brain. And it is seen just behind to the cerebrum. You can see just behind to the cerebrum, we can see the cerebellum. And this cerebellum contains fissures and grooves with two flaps. You can see in the video, two flaps are also seen here. And this cerebellum has another peculiarity. Two functions are controlling by the cerebellum. One is, it coordinates muscular activities. What is the meaning of muscular activities? That means running, jumping, walking, controlled by the cerebellum. And another function is that it maintains the equilibrium of the body. That means balancing of the body is also controlled by the cerebellum. The next one is the thalamus. You can see the position of thalamus is, it is seen just below to the cerebrum. And the peculiarity of thalamus is, it acts as a relay station of impulses. That means the main center of impulses is the thalamus. It is the thalamus who sends important impulses to the cerebrum. That's why it is called the relay station. The thalamus acts as a relay station of impulses to and from the cerebrum. Our next part is the hypothalamus. Hypothalamus means which is seen just below to the thalamus, and its function is it maintains homeostasis. Homeostasis means it controls all the body activities such as hunger, thirst. Okay, our last part is the medulla oblongata. Medulla oblongata, which is seen just below to the cerebrum, near to the cerebellum. The shape of the medulla oblongata is rod shape. The function of medulla oblongata is it controls involuntary activity. This means the movement which does not take by our will is called involuntary actions. The examples, heartbeat, breathing, or what all actions taking place internal our body, that is called the involuntary activities. So the function of medulla oblongata is it controls involuntary activities such as heartbeat, breathing, etc. So we discussed about different parts and their function. Watch this video continuously. This is very important diagram. Don't forget to write its parts and functions in the notebook. Learn it clearly. Watch the video continuously. Only this much for today. Thanks for watching. Bye.